the sun has gone down, and what are we about to do?
So I turned 21 on the 15th of July, this Monday, 2 days' time. And so Sage and I have decided to go up to Harvey Bay, where we fell in love with our little 14-foot catamaran. And we're going to sail to Fraser Island and spend the week on Fraser. And just be in nature, which we love very much. And
this is going to be our first ocean passage. As me, as a captain of a vessel, and as Emily is a first mate, and as us as a couple, this is going to be our first ocean passage. So I'm sure we're going to learn a lot. I'm sure we're going to up in areas. I'm sure we're going to do great in areas, and I'm sure that you are going to be able to watch it all. So day two, we drove for a few hours last night, drove till we couldn't drive anymore. I actually learned how to drive a manual car at about 10 o'clock last night for the first time,
with
a boat behind the car as well. So that was a learning experience. We're finally rocking up to the boat harbour, and we're super excited to get on the water and this adventure undergoing. But what we need to do first is set up the catamaran and attach our swag to the boat. Make sure that we have everything tied down properly so that we don't lose anything overboard and we're good to go. Just launched the boat from Yurungan Boat Harbour with the destination of Fraser Island, and you can see it in the distance way over there if you have a good squint. But at the moment we can't get our sails quite set and get the right trajectory, so we're using a paddle to push the side of the sail out so that it has a bit more of an area for the wind to hit. We made it. We were quite surprised with the lack of wind there was at the beginning, but then halfway across we really got some nice wind and got the boat moving. We were moving at like 6.5 knots at one point. Harvey Bay, here we come!
Woo, baby! What are we gonna have for dinner? So, we are just about to hit land for the first time. It took us probably about 2 hours, maybe a bit longer. The journey was pretty, it varied a lot. There was some was like where we had pretty strong gusts and I was scared that we were gonna tip the boat, but it was so fine. And then there was moments like this. At the beginning we were fighting the current pretty hard and we were moving at like 2 knots. And we're like, we're gonna be going anywhere. Weren't too sure if we were gonna make it here before dark.
But check out where we made it to. We should seriously be pulling our boat up and finding a camp.
we making for breakfast, babe?
We're having oats with apple and cinnamon and banana.
And how are we cooking it?
Stirring it with a stick on the fire.
Our firewood for the night, and camp is just right here. Tuesday morning, and our plan for the day is to go to the nearest river, sail downwind with the wind behind us, and then about halfway through the day the wind should shift from side shore to offshore to allow us to get back. So that's going to be the plan for the day.
Jumping up and down the floor, my hat is an animal, and once there was an animal, it had a son that mowed the lawn. The son was an okay guy, they had a pet dragonfly. Dragonfly, it ran away, but it came back with a story to say.
One time I went to FRASER Island on a 14-foot catamaran and went for a day sail and completely lost wind on the way back to camp. And also that moment is now, and we're paddling all the way back.
It's complete.
With the tide.
With the tide, of course. The tide's our friend here. And it's moments like these that make you appreciate life. Investing in experiences over possessions will always lead you to beautiful moments in life in which you can cherish. That is why we are so grateful for the beautiful land in which we walk upon, the clean air that we breathe, and the beautiful water that we swim in. And that's why we need to protect it.